is MadDog2001 coming to you with another video. Basically, this video is going to be about yours truly, well, not yours truly, but this truly, Kurt Angle. Basically, I've said this before, but Kurt Angle did not get the right, I don't think he got enough time at the top at the WWE to really, at least he never had a lengthy title reign, and I think that was part of the reason why he left. He never really got a chance to carry the company on his shoulders or something like that. They didn't trust him. I never understood that. He was over with the crowd. Everyone, not any wrestling fan or just about anyone knows who Kurt Angle is. I mean, he's typically a household name. Olympic gold medalist. Most people don't know him for that, unless if they're in Pittsburgh. But he was a household name, not as big as The Rock or Stone Cold, but he is a household name when it comes into wrestling. When people talk about the best wrestlers of all time, he is brought up in that conversation. I mean, you know, Bret Hart is brought up, Kurt Angle is brought up. I'm talking about mainstream wrestling. Those two are brought up a lot. Ric Flair, you know? All those guys are household names, and Kurt Angle is one of those household wrestling names in today's era of wrestling. So I don't understand why he never got a lengthy title reign. I mean, his longest title reign, I think, was his first one, where he won the title at No Mercy and then lost it at No Way Out, which was total bullshit. Basically, it's like, how does Kurt win a Hell in a Cell match and then lose to The Rock, who lost in the Royal Rumble? I mean, it didn't make any sense. It was basically to build... It made sense for WrestleMania 17 for Austin The Rock. It's going to make a lot more money than Austin Angle, at least during that time. I can understand that. But, I mean, Kurt Angle really... He was over pretty much right away. I mean, he was brought in with this character, and he never changed this. He's had this character. I mean, he was brought in as like a baby face type wrestler that the fans didn't like. So then he turned into a cocky guy, came out and insulted everyone in the crowd. See, in wrestling, we don't want to know about their competence. We don't care. As wrestling fans, and I think, I don't know if he was brought in as a heel right away, but I mean, I don't know if that was their intention. I don't think it was their intention right away, because they had him go against Daisy to start off. But then, basically with Kurt, is I think he was a little bit, that I can understand. He was in the same era with The Rock and Austin at that time. When The Rock and Austin left, That to me, it was time for Kurt Angle to get to the top, and, you know, he's had the title, but he never had the major title. I mean, he's had the WWE Championship when it was on SmackDown, which, at the time, Raw was a higher name show, even though SmackDown, I thought, was a little bit better than Raw. He had some great feuds with Lesnar, but once when Lesnar left, it was just like, all right, Lesnar's gone. It's Kurt's time, you know. Kurt has got to be at that top. He's got to have the championship, and I want a long title run with him. He never got that. The time I thought they should have gave him that title is when he feuded with John Cena in 2005. Had a pretty good feud with him. Made Cena look really good. I mean, the fact they did everything they possibly could do to get Cena to get the cheers. I mean, this is when he was getting booed. He started getting booed probably right when he was feuding with Angle, I think, because there's Kurt Angle fans. There's a lot of wrestling Kurt Angle fans out there. The fact is, they should have gave him that title. He deserved that title. Basically, you know, he beat Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 21, and then lost to Booker T in some stupid match, and they kind of washed that away like it didn't exist. But then, something really good was happening with him. Right when he got drafted to Raw, it looks like they were going to start a little bit of feud with him and Batista. And they killed that off. And I thought that would have been an interesting feud, because Batista's a powerhouse wrestler, Angle's a technical wrestler. I thought it would have been a good match. At the time, that's when I thought Batista was actually had potential. Lately he's gotten lazy. But the fact is that Kurt should have got that, in my mind, that long title run. The title run that Triple H got, the title run that John Cena, who got it, who didn't deserve it. I understand why he got it, because he was the most over guy in the company. Which, at the time, I don't think he was. He was getting booed. There were some, I know that doesn't mean, but you know, he's supposed to be at the base, he's supposed to get cheered. Kurt Angle was getting cheered, and he was a heel. Something was wrong with him. They booed Cena. The only way they could have got Cena to get cheers is when they had him face Edge. Because Edge was probably the most hated heel on Raw. I mean, that's probably a fact right there at that time. He was the most hated heel on Raw. But with Kurt Angle, they desperately tried to get Cena these two. Kurt Angle would go on and bash the troops. He would talk about how he'd insult the crowd. He even got Daivari, the special guest referee, in line with, the terrorists. It's kind of crazy. So, I mean, they did everything they possibly could to put Kurt, to make Kurt Angle put Cena over, and it just was not working. Kurt Angle said, he doesn't say that was the reason why he left. He said it was because of scheduling and all that kind of stuff. But, honestly, I'm pretty sure that has to be a big reason. But he thought that these guys, that these no-talent wrestlers were put ahead of him. Like Batista, Kurt, John Cena, even fucking Mark Henry, Rey Mysterio, who a great wrestler and does deserve the title run, but he's not world heavyweight contendership material in my mind. He's too much of a face. He has no, he's like the hero, you know, kind of like John Cena was. And people don't like that. You need to have like a badass face like Stone Cold Steve Austin. He basically, I don't even tell us how that happened, but Kurt had this gimmick and it worked for him. This is part, I'm going to make another part of this video because I got some more to cover. But this is Mad Dog 2001. Leave comments, subscribe, do whatever the fuck you guys feel like. I don't know. I'm up to 16 now, so I think this new camera's working.